फैबेसी और कॉन्जर्ड नेम लेग्यूमनोसी। फैमिली लेग्यूमनोसी हैज़ 360 जनरा एंड अबाउट 18,000 स्पेसिस। लेग्यूमनोसी फैमिली इज वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट फैमिली आफ्टर अस्टरेसी। अस्टरेसी इज द गैमोपेटली फैमिली विच हैज़ ए लार्जेस्ट नंबर विच इज़ फॉलोड बाय आर्किडेसी एंड दिस लेग्यूमनोसी फैमिली इज द थर्ड लार्जेस्ट फैमिली। फैमिली फैबेसी इज सब डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री सब फैमिलीज। फर्स्ट वन इज अ सिजालपिनेसी, सेकेंड वन इज अ पैपिलियोनेसी एंड थर्ड वन इज ए माइमोसेसी। टुडे वी विल डील अबाउट फैमिली पैपिलियोनेसी। बिफोर गोइंग इन डिटेल अबाउट फैमिली पैपिलियोनेसी, जस्ट सी सम ऑफ द मेम्बर्स ऑफ फैमिली पैपिलियोनेसी। सो फॉर द सेक ऑफ सिंप्लिसिटी, जस्ट सी दिस वन इमेज। दिस इज इमेज ऑफ डालबर्जिया सीसो प्लांट। द वर्नेकुलर नेम इज अ शीरिश प्लांट एंड इज वन ऑफ द टिम्बर प्लांट। ओके, जस्ट सी दिस वन इज द हैबिट ऑफ द प्लांट। दिज आर द फ्लावर्स, ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व द इनफ्लोरेसेंस प्रेजेंट इन दिस फ्लावर। दिस वन पार्ट, दिस वन इज द कैलिक्स एंड दिस वन इज अ प्यूबेसेंट। दिस इज अ वाइट कलर्ड कोरोला इज प्रेजेंट। सी द दिस बेसल वन फिगर, दिस इज ए वन ऑफ द ट्विग फ्रॉम डालबर्जिया सीसो प्लांट। दिस वन इज इनफ्लोरेसेंस। जस्ट सी द लीव्स ऑल्सो, वॉट टाइप ऑफ फाइलोटैक्स इज प्रेजेंट, वेदर इट इज अ ग्लैबरस और प्यूबेसेंट। ओके, सो दिस इज अबाउट द डालबर्जिया प्लांट। दिस वन इज अगेन वन ऑफ द फैमिलियर प्लांट, ब्यूटिया मोनोस्पर्मा। ओके, वर्नाकुलर नेम इज ए पलस। दिस वन इज ए फ्लावर यील्डिंग प्लांट, फ्लावर विच यील्ड्स ऑयल एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट इन यूरिनरी एंड मेंस्ट्रुअल ट्रबल। जस्ट सी द हैबिट ऑफ दिस ब्यूटिया प्लांट, वॉट टाइप ऑफ ब्यूटी इज प्रेजेंट। दिस इज ए वन ऑफ द इनफ्लोरेसेंस। जस्ट सी द कलर ऑफ द फ्लावर, द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ फ्लावर ऑन द फ्लोरल एक्सिस। सो दिस इज ए ब्यूटिया मोनोस्पर्मा। वन मोर प्लांट फ्रॉम फैमिली पैपिलियोनेसी विच इज क्वाइट फैमिलियर टू एवरी वन, ट्रैगोनेला फोइनम ग्रैसियम। वर्नाकुलर नेम इज ए मेथी। यूजुअली दिस वेजिटेबल क्रॉप इज यूज फॉर यूज्ड एज ए वेजिटेबल पर्पज, लीफी वेजिटेबल। सीड्स आर यूज्ड इन कॉन्डिमेंट्स एंड ऑल्सो मेडिसिनली फॉर डायबिटिक्स। सो जस्ट सी दिस इज ए मेथी प्लांट। See the inflorescence present here, and this one is a single flower. So Trigonella foinum gracium, this one plant. Then one of the important plant which is usually sown by farmers for the purpose of green manuring, this is a Crotalaria juncea. Vernacular name is a ताग प्लांट। यूजुअली महाराष्ट्रियन पीपल सोन इट ड्यूरिंग द रेनी सीजन बिफोर द प्लांटेशन ऑफ ओनियन। सो दिस इज ए क्रोटोलारिया जुन्सिया प्लांट यूज्ड इन ग्रीन मैन्यूरिंग एंड दिस वन इज ऑल्सो यूज टू ऑब्टेन द फाइबर्स। यूजुअली द स्टेम, मैच्योर्ड प्लांट्स स्टेम yields fiber and this fiber is used in the preparation of ropes as well as in gunny bags. Just see the inflorescence. Okay, this one is a corolla region. See the habit of the plant, whether it is a herb, shrub or tree. One more important plant is the Pongamia pinnata, Curran's plant. Okay, one of the most important source of biodiesel. So this one is a tree plant. Okay, the seeds of the Pongamia plant are yields oil, which is used in a skin disease and is best source for biodiesel. Just see the twig of this Pongamia plant. Just see the habit of the plant, then nature of the leaves. Just see the inflorescence, how the inflorescence looks like. So this one is a Pongamia pinnata plant. One more plant from the same family, Papilionaceae. This is a pulse crop, Vigna unguiculata, Chavuli plant. Chavuli is a Marathi name. Just see the habit of the plant. Then these are the pods or legumes. Then this one is a typical flower. Just see the beauty of the flower. Okay, Papilionaceae type of corolla is present in family Papilionaceae, and you can observe such a type of a corolla is present here. This one of the familiar plant, pea plant, Pisum sativum, which is used as a seed vegetable. Just see the habit of the plant. This is the nature of leaf. You see the tendrils which are present here. This is a stipule. Okay, these are the pods or legume. This one is a typical flower. Okay, so these characters are helpful for describing the family. You can consider any one plant and use it as a character of family. Okay, so this one is a typical figure of a pea plant. A legume type of fruit is present here. These are the stipules, foliaceous stipules are present. These are pinnately compound type of the leaves. This one is the tendril. And as you see here, completely herbaceous nature, or not only the herbaceous nature, but the nature, climber nature of the plant. This one figure, see here, this one figure here. Okay, so this one is the Phaseolus vulgaris bean plant, Gevda, which is again the seed plant. Just see the habit, see the nature of leaves. These are the pods, again herbaceous habit. See the typical inflorescence. Just see the seeds. These are again legumes. So this is a Phaseolus vulgaris. One more plant which is used in masticatory. The leaves of such a plant is used in masticatory. So Abrus precatorius, Gunza plant. These are the seeds of the Abrus precatorius, and this one is a pod of the plant. This one is the diagrammatic presentation of a plant. But just see the pinnately compound type of the leaves. Then the nature, which one is a climber nature of the plant. So you can again observe here the nature of the flowers or nature of the inflorescence. Okay, so this one is a Abrus precatorius. Then next one of the most important forage crop. This is a generally called as a alfalfa plant, Medicago sativa. Okay, which is used for the domestic animals and is a best forage crop. alpha alpha 1. See the nature of the leaves, the herbaceous habit of the plant, the inflorescence, and these are the flowers. You see the nature of the leaves. Okay, again, see one more figure of the family Papilionaceae. This is a Arachis hypogea, Bhuimukh plant. Okay, Arachis hypogea, this is a leguminous plant or Papilionaceous plant. The seed used to obtain oil, which is used for the cooking purpose. It is also used in the preparation of vanaspati ghee, and oil cake is used for the cattle feed as well as for fertilizer. So just see the herbaceous nature of the plant, the nature of leaves, the nature of flowers. Okay, this is a diagrammatic presentation of the plant, the leaves, the inflorescence. Just see the inflorescence, what type of inflorescence is present here. Then this is a lomentum type of the fruit. Okay, and this one is the seed. So these are the some figures or images from family Leguminosae. This one is again one more plant, not one more, two more plants. This is a Vigna aconitifolia, this one plant, and this one is a Vigna radiata. Vigna radiata plant, and this one is a mert plant, mert, and this one is a udid. Both are the pulse crops. So if you see here, just see the nature of the pod, simple, dry, dehiscent type of the fruits completely observed here. Then you can see how the nature of leaves are present here. See the nature of the flowers which are present here. These are the seeds of a mert plant, Vigna aconitifolia. So these are some of the images of family Papilionaceae. Before going in detail, again just see some more plant, some more images which are helpful for the purpose of understanding of the family. So these are the leaves. This is a simple type of a leaf. This is a both figures, this one and this one. These are compound leaves. This is a pinnately compound leaf, while this one is a palmately compound leaf. If you see the typical single leaf, just see what are the parts of the leaf. This is the region of the stem. This one is the region of a node. Okay, these are the stipules. So stipules arises where the petiole incises to the stem. It may be either leaf like or scale like, but this is called as a stipule. If leaf possesses stipule, then that leaf is called as a stipulate. And when such a type of a stipule absent, then it is called as a ex-stipulate. The stalk of the leaf, which is called as a petiole. And if petiole present, then that leaf is called as a petiolate leaf. Otherwise, it is called as a sessile leaf. This is a bird, a vegetative bird, maybe the floral bird or vegetative bird, but this is the bird, and this bird is present at the region of a axis. That's why it is called as a axillary bird. Okay, so this is a axillary bird which is present here. What is open? Okay, this is the region, this is a midrib region. Then this one is a margin. These are the lateral vein. This is the region. What happened here? This is the teep region. Leaf teep is present. This one is a blade, and this one region is a base of the flower. See these figures again. These are the shapes of the leaf. This is a elliptical shape of the leaf. This is a lanceolate shape. Okay, this is ovoid, lenticular to approaching circular in shape. This is ovoid shape, most common shape. Then ovate and obovate, both these shapes are also most common shapes which are found in majority of the family plants. Then these are the some figures which shows the nature of corolla. This is a infundibuliform type of a corolla. This one is a gamopetalous regular type of corolla. 5 petals unites together, and it usually form such a type of a funnel shaped structure, and that's why it is called as a infundibuliform, or this one is also called as a funnel shaped corolla. Okay, this is a papilionaceous corolla. In family Papilionaceae, you will observe this one type of a corolla. Papilionaceous type of corolla is a irregular and polypetalous type of corolla. 5 petals are present. One of the petal is the largest, which is present on outer side, which is called as a standard. It encloses 2 petals called the wing, and inside the wing again 2 innermost petals present. They are called as a keel or carina. So this one is a papilionaceous type of corolla. This is a campanulate or bell shaped corolla. Regular and gamopetalous type of corolla. Bilabiate, this one is irregular and gamopetalous type of corolla. Usually bilabiate or two leaped corolla. Usually it forms 2+3, upper lip and lower lip. So it form the bilabiate corolla. Rotate type of corolla, this one is the tube, and these are the lobes. Here lobes are almost perpendicular to the tube at the apex point or at the region of the throat. Then this one is called as a rotate type of corolla. This one is a tubular corolla. All these corolla are gamopetalous one. So this one is again gamopetalous and a regular type of a corolla. The width of the corolla tube is almost more or less equal from this point to this point, and that's why it is called as a tubular corolla. This is a cruciform corolla. This one is a polypetalous and gamopetalous corolla, where petals are present in a cross, and each petal is present at 90 degree to another one petal. Then this one is a ligulate type of corolla. Ligulate is a, again irregular plus gamopetalous type of corolla. Usually this ligulate type of corolla forms a strap shaped structure. This is the point. This is the union. So at the base, this petal is united, but it becomes free from this one point. So it looks as a prepetal, but this one is a gamopetalous one. So ligulate or strap shaped or band shaped corolla. Then this one is a spurred corolla. One of the petal, as we observe here, this is a gamopetalous type of corolla. One of the petal forms such a type of a bag like structure, or this is a nectar secreting structure. This one is called as a spur. If such a type of a beautifully placed corolla is present, then this one is called as a spurred corolla. Again, just see some more figures from the This one figure. This is typical figure of the leaf. The different parts of the leaf. This one is the region of the stem. This is the region of node. As you know, only at the node, leaf or flower or any type of vegetative bud will be present. So this is the region of bud. This is a petiole, okay, which is a stalk of the leaf. These are the stipules. This greenish colored part is the stipule. This base, this is the region which is called as a pulvinous base of the leaf. These are the glands. Usually these glands are nectar secreting gland. Whatever essence or is fragrance present to plant, it is due to the presence of such a type of a gland. See, this one is the nature of a leaf. This is the apex region. This one is a region of a lamina, or also called as a blade. Then just see the margin. This is one type of margin. This one is a entire margin, smooth margin. Okay, this is a serrate margin, like a dent or a teeth like structures, saw like teeth are present, then it is called as a serrate type of the margin. This is lacinate type of the margin. You can differentiate by observing only the figure. Okay, so this one is a undulate type of a margin. So these are the margins of the leaf, different types of the margin you can observe here. This is a lamina or a leaf blade. This entire green colored structure is the lamina. This is a sinus. It is just like a depression or a furrow like region. This one is a sinus region. These are the lobes. Okay, here single lobe is present. You can also consider this one as a lobed structure. So such a type raised part of the leaf margin which form a lobe like structure, then that is called as a lobe. So this one is a midrib region. These are the veins. And again, such a type of veins again present here. These are called as a lateral vein. So this is a typical figure of a leaf. Here again, one more figure, just for the tendrils and stipule. This is from the papillonis family. These are the tendrils. Okay, these are the flowers. And this one is a stipule. Here stipule looks like a leaf, foliaceous leaf. You know the term foliaceous. So foliaceous stipule is present here. These are the leaflets, and this one is a figure of a twig. One more figure I want to share with you, and this one is a insertion of a floral leaves on the thalamus, and on that basis flower may be hypogynous or epigynous or perigynous. Just see, this is a calyx region, corolla region, androecium region, and this one is a gynoecium. This is a typical ovary, while this one greenish colored part is a thalamus. Okay, in every family, in every figure. So here see the position of ovary. Oh, this ovary is present at the top of this thalamus, and the other floral holes, calyx, corolla, androecium, these arises below the ovary attached to the thalamus. So here ovary is present at the top. So this one is a superior type of ovary, and such a type of a flower is called as a hypogynous type of the flower. If you see, completely opposite condition to hypogyny is the epigyny or epigynous type of the flower. Here green colored part is a part of the thalamus. Okay, so this one is a thalamus region, this is a calyx region, corolla region, region of androecium. This is a typical stigma, then style region. Okay, this is a ovary. Which one ovary? This entire part is the ovary. So here ovary is present at the base. Okay, and other floral holes like calyx, corolla, androecium present at the top of the ovary attached to the thalamus. Okay, so here ovary is present at the basal one region. So this one is called as a inferior type of a ovary. So this is an inferior ovary, and flower is a epigynous one. And this one is the condition in between hypogynous and epigynous. One will observe the perigynous condition. This is the region of thalamus, this is a calyx, this one is a corolla, androecium, this one is a gynoecium, and this one is the ovary. Just see here. Okay, so here ovary is neither superior nor inferior. Here all the floral holes, calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium, present at an equal level. Half of the part of the ovary is present into the thalamus, while half of the part of the ovary is present above the thalamus. Then this one is called as a perigynous condition. This one condition, this is a calyx, corolla, androecium, and this one is a gynoecium. This is a cup-shaped thalamus. This is not exactly the perigynous type of the flower. This one figure is completely showing perigynous condition, and ovary in such a flower is considered as a semi-inferior ovary. So hypogynous flower, perigynous flower, and epigynous type of the flower. So these are again some of the figure from the lomentum fruit. In family Papilionaceae, you will observe lomentum or pod type of the fruit. These are Mimosa pudica, Lazaro plant, groundnut, bhuimukh plant. Then this one is Amaltas, this one is Acacia. This is a somewhat different. These are the members from family Mimosaceae. So this is the part which is called as a mericarp, and it shows a constricted region between the region of the seed. Such a type of a fruits are called as a lomentum type of the fruits. Okay, so these are also the dehiscent type of the fruits. Just see about the Papilionaceae family. We see the characters of family Papilionaceae. Then it is a subfamily from Fabaceae or Leguminosae. Family Papilionaceae, according to Bentham and Hooker, the name Papilionaceae is Papilionidae. Okay, about 440 genera and 12,800 species of family Papilionaceae are recorded all over the world. These are cosmopolitan, which is observed throughout the world and present in the warm climate as well as in a temperate climate, or warm region and temperate region of the world. If you see the habit, then almost every type of the habit is present here. It may be climber one, this one herb, then shrubs, then trees. So the plants like Dalbergia, Erythrina, these are from the tree category. Tephrosia plant, then Indigofera, Alhagi, such a type of the plants are from shrub category. Or Herbaceous one, Mililotus plant, or Medicago sativa plant. This shows herb habit. Sometimes it shows climber, and this one is a woody climber, which is generally considered as a lien. Wisteria plant shows woody climber nature. One important character from the family Papilionaceae, that these plant possesses root nodules. Okay, and these root nodules play significant role in a symbiotic nitrogen fixation. Usually, rhizobium type of a bacteria live in a symbiotic association in the roots of this papilionaceous plant. Root, taproot system, as it is a dicot plant, so taproot system will be present, and this root again shows branched structure, and the root possesses root nodules. Just see the nature of the stem. According to the habit, if herb habit is present, then the stem will be herbaceous. If shrub or tree category present, then the stem will be woody. If climber habit is present, then the stem will be climbing. It is erect. Okay, so it is a aerial one, and erect, it is again branched. This one is a particular dicot character. Then woody, as well as it is a solid. In case of herbaceous plant, it will be woody or herbaceous, and usually it is a solid in structure. Okay, so just see about the leaves again. Leaves alternate. Okay, leaves alternate. If you see the phyllotaxis, the arrangement of leaves on the stem, this one is called as a phyllotaxy. So the leaves are alternately present. It shows either alternate, opposite, or whole type of phyllotaxy. So this is one which is called as a alternate type of the phyllotaxy. Leaves are compound. Okay, and in compound, it shows pinnately compound as well as palmately compound type of the leaves. Okay, see this one figure. This is a simple leaf. These are pinnately compound and these are palmately compound. Okay, so leaves may be either simple or compound. If compound, they may be pinnately compound or palmately compound. Sometimes it is a simple one. In some cases, the leaves modify into tendrils, leaf base, sometimes also the basis of the leaflets, as it is a compound type of the leaf, it is a pulvinate. So pulvinate type of the base, here the petiole shows such a type of a broader structure. Okay, so solen structure, then that base is called as a pulvinate base. So you have seen this one figure again. So these are the tendrils. Okay, these are the tendrils, leaf tendrils, and this is a pulvinous base. Okay, so these are the characters of the leaf. Stipules present, different types of the stipules present, and here leaves are stipulate. Then next one is about the inflorescence. Arrangement of flower on the floral axis is called as the inflorescence, and here racemose type of inflorescence is present, and is present in a raceme. So in a case of raceme type of inflorescence, elongated axis is present, which is called as a peduncle, and on this peduncle you will observe bracteate or ebracteate pedicellate flower arranged in a acropetal succession. Okay, so this one is the first flower, second flower, third flower, while the buds are present at the apex. So racemose type of inflorescence, here this one is an indefinite type of inflorescence. Flowers are present in acropetal type of succession or centripetal type of succession, then that is called as a racemose type of inflorescence. This one is a typical raceme type of inflorescence. Then again, head type of inflorescence is present. Head type, here the peduncle is this peduncle is present in the form of receptacle. It is broader or it forms a saucer like structure, and florets are present in a centripetal manner. Usually the head type of inflorescence is also called as a capitulum type of inflorescence. This type of inflorescence is usually observed in family Asteraceae. Okay, ray florets are present towards periphery, while disc florets are present towards the center. The central florets are younger one, while the peripheral flowers are older in case of head or capitulum type of inflorescence. In Uranus, spike type of inflorescence is also observed. Spike type and raceme type are same inflorescence. Only the difference is, in case of racemous type of inflorescence, these flowers are pedicellate, while in case of spike, this pedicel is absent, so the flowers will be present in such a manner. Sessile flowers present in acropetal succession, then that is called as a spike type of inflorescence. Next one is a flower. So flowers are bracteate. Usually the stalk, suppose this one is a stem, this is a pedicel, and suppose this one is a flower, then such a type of a either leafy or scale like appendage if present at the place of origin of flower, then this one is called as a bract. And if such a type of a bract is present in a flower, then that is called as a bracteate flower. And if such a bract if absent, then it is called as a ebracteate type of flower. Bracts are often caducous. Caducous means ephemeral. These bracts falls off as soon as the flower opens. The flowers are bisexual. Okay, that means presence of a hole of androecium and gynoecium, both reproductive holes if present, then that is called as a bisexual or hermaphrodite flower. Then flower is a zygomorphic. Zygomorphic, that means irregular flower. Here flower cannot be divided into number of planes into equal part if we cut it vertically. So zygomorphic type of flower can be divided only in a single plane. Okay, then perigynous type of flower, and flower is a complete one if the holes calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium, if all floral holes if present in a flower, then that flower is called as a complete flower. Any of the hole if missing, okay, out of four, any one of the hole if missing, then that flower is considered as a incomplete flower. There are very much controversies about the complete flower and incomplete flower. Some authors or taxonomists consider the perianth bearer flowers as a complete flower. But just consider here, if all four floral holes if present, then consider that flower as a complete flower. Okay, just see about the calyx, the outermost hole of the flower. Usually it is a the number of sepals are 5, more or less united. More or less united, that means gamosepalous condition is present, but maybe polysepalous condition will be present. Usually campanulate. Campanulate means bell shape. Okay, bell shape type of a as you see here, we have already seen the figure about the types of corolla. No doubt, no problem about it may be the shape of a corolla or calyx. This is a bell-shaped structure, and such a type of bell-shaped structure is observed in calyx region. Therefore, it is called as a campanulate calyx. One sepal is odd. One odd sepal is present, which is present anteriorly. Okay, so some of the diagnostic characters of the family Papaver and Asi. This one sepal anterior is one of the diagnostic character of family papilionaceae. Then just say about the corolla. If you see here, this one is a typical figure from the Clitoria ternati, Gokarna plant. So this is a climber plant. This is a campanulate type of a calyx, and this one is one of the odd sepal. Okay, just see about the corolla. Okay, this is a corolla which is a papilionaceous type of corolla. Papilionaceous type of corolla consists of 5 petals, and these 5 petals are present 1 plus 2 plus 2 which are united. This is a outermost petal. This petal is called as a standard, or this one is called as a vexillum. Okay, this is the outermost petal. This outermost petal encloses 2 inner petals. They are called as wings or alli. So these wings are present inside the standard, and again these wings enclose 2 petals which are fused at the tip region. They are called as a carina or kill. So this is a papilionaceous type of a corolla which is present in family Papilionaceae. So 5 petals present, even though the innermost petals show not actually they are united, only the tip of these petals is united one. Okay, so corolla is a 5 petalous. It is a polypetalous. Polypetalous means free petals, consisting posterior as a standard or vexillum. It encloses 2 lateral wings, or they are also called as alli, and 2 anterior innermost petals fuse along the margin, which forms the keel or carina, which encloses the stamens and pistils. Posterior petal is a outermost, which is called as a standard one. Okay, so standard, wings and gills. Just say about the androecium. Usually in a family Papilionaceae, 10 stamens are present, and these 10 stamens may be present in a diadelphous condition or monoadelphous condition in case of Ononis, or they may be polyandrous in case of Sophrora plants or Thermopsis. Anthers are bithycus, and dehiscence is a longitudinal one. So 10 stamens are present. Just see the Clitoria ternati case. This is a condition of diadelphous condition. Okay, so before going diadelphous, this is a union of stamens. Union of stamens shows either adhesion or cohesion. Okay, cohesion shows union of stamens among themselves. If you see such a type of a condition, this is the anther, and this one is a filament one. So union of anther and filament, or anther or filament, is called as a cohesion. So union of stamens among themselves is the cohesion, and this cohesion shows adelphi, then called as a syngeny, then called as a synandry. In case of adelphi, filaments unites and anthers remains free. In case of syngeny, which is observed in Asteraceae family, anthers remains united and filaments remains free, whilst in synandry both anther and filament are united. If you say the Clitoria, this is a diadelphous condition. Adelphi means bundle. Okay, this adelphi may be monoadelphi, diadelphi, polyadelphi. Mono means single. So if union of filament form a single bundle, single adelphi, then it is called as a monoadelphi. And if it forms two bundles, this is a one bundle, which shows the fusion of nine stamens, and this one stamen is a free one. So these 9 stamen form a single bundle, while this remaining one stamen form another one bundle. So there are two bundles are present, and that's why this condition is called as a diadelphous condition. In case of Rutaceae family, you will observe polyadelphous condition. So here, in case of Androsium, 10 stamens are present, diadelphous condition is present, one posterior stamen remains free, and filaments of 9 stamens fuse into a tube which open posteriorly. In Smithia plant, stamens shows diadelphous condition 5 plus 5. It may be whether it is a diadelphous or only the polyandrous condition present. Maybe the 5 stamens may be the smaller in size, and 5 stamens may be the larger in size. Whatever may be the case condition, but 5 plus 5 condition is present in the Smithia plant. Then monadelphous condition is present in Ononis. All the 10 stamens may be fused in a single bundle. Then it will produce the monadelphous condition. It shows the polyandrous condition. Stamens, the anthers which are present in these stamens shows such a type of a dithecous condition, and longitudinal dehiscence present in the anthers. Just say about the gynoecium, the innermost whorl of the flower, which is the female reproductive organ, gynoecium, and individual member is either called as a carpel or a pistil. So monocarpellary condition is present, single carpel, mono means one, carpel, carpellary, okay. Unilocular, then many ovules present in each locule, single locule is present. So many locules are present in a locule, many ovules are present in a locule. Ovary is considered as a superior one, and marginal type of placentation is present here. In case of marginal type of placentation, such a type of a condition is usually observed. This is a ovule, many ovule may be present. This is a ovary wall, and this one is a chamber or a locule. This one is considered as a ventral suture of the ovary, while this one is considered as a dorsal suture of the ovary. Okay, so this is a marginal type of a placentation, where the placenta originates from the ventral suture of the ovary. Style is single and curved. Fruit is a legume or pod, or rarely lomentum. Legume or pod type of the fruits are simple type of the fruits. These are simple, then dry type of the fruits. In case of dry type of the fruits, what is the fruit? It is a matured and fertilized ovary is the fruit. Then if the fruit develops from a single flower with Syncarpus gynoecium, then that fruit is called as a simple type of the fruit. Usually a fruit shows two regions. Okay, just see one of the very simple figure. So this is a mango fruit, and this one part is called as a seed, while outer one region is called as a pericarp. Okay, so here pericarp, okay, this is a pericarp. If pericarp is differentiated into epicarp, then mesocarp or endocarp, then it is called as a fleshy type of the fruits. And when this pericarp region, epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp, is papery, it just form a skin like structure, then that fruit is called as a dry fruit. So in case of family Papilionaceae, simple dry fruits are present. Again, these dry fruits are again of two categories. It may be dehiscent or indehiscent. Indehiscent type of the fruit do not dehisce after their maturity, while dehiscent type of the fruit dehisces after their maturity. So legume or pod type of the fruits are simple dry dehiscent type of the fruits, or rarely it may be lomentum type of the fruits. Just see the saline characters or diagnostic features or diagnostic characters of family papilionaceae. Leaves usually pinnately compound with pulvinate base. Okay. Flowers usually zygomorphic. Corolla papilionaceous. Sepals united and one odd sepal is anterior. Usually stamens 10. Shows diadelphous condition. 9 united, 1 free. Ovary usually superior, monocarpellary. Fruit is a pod or legume, or it may be lumentum. So these are the diagnostic feature or cell and characters of family Papilionaceae. Just see the systematic position proposed by Bentham and Hooker in a natural system of classification. Kingdom is the phanerogam, as flowering plants are present. Class is the dicotyledon, where different characters are present here. Reticular type of venation, then seed with two cotyledon, branched stem, taproot system, pentamerous or tetramerous flower. All these are the characters of the dicotyledons. Then subclass is a polypetaly. In case of polypetaly, perianth are absent. That means both calyx and corolla are present, and the individual member of corolla called petal is a free one. Ceres is a calyciflora. Okay. Thalamus is a cup shape. Flowers perigynous. Disc absent. Disc usually present in the disciflora series, and sepals united. Then order is the rosales. Flower perigynous one, and carpels not united. Usually in Papilionaceae family, single carpel is present and there is no problem whether they are united or free. Then family is a Fabaceae or Leguminosae. Leaves with stipules, that means stipulate leaves. Lip base pulvinate at the base of the petiole. Such a type of a swollen structure is present. Then this one is called as a pulvinate base. One odd sepal is present anteriorly. Carpel single, marginal placentation, and legume type of the fruit. And subfamily is Papilionaceae. Flowers zygomorphic, sepals united, petals papilionaceous, stamens 9 plus 1, 9 united, 1 free. In case of Dalbergia plant, monoadelphous stamen. Fruit may be legume or lumentum. Just see the economical importance of family Papilionaceae. First one use is food. Most of the important pulse crop. Okay, pulses use as a food, rich source of proteins, and common species are the pulses. Okay, then fodder plants. Most important forage crops includes Medicago sativa, then Vicia melilotus, Trifolium. These plants are used as a forage or a fodder for domestic animals. Timber, Butea monosperma or Dalbergia sisu type of the plants yields a timber quality wood, which is used for building purpose or furniture purpose as well as fuel purpose. Then vegetable oil. The plant like Arachis hypoxia, Bhuimukh plant or peanut plant, the seeds are edible. From seed, oil is obtained. This oil is used for cooking purpose. It is also used for the preparation of the vanaspati ghee. Oil cake is used as a cattle feed or also used as a fertilizer. Okay, then some of the plants also yields dye, which is usually used in textile industry, and the oil, the dye is yellow or indigo in color. Then there are some of the plants which are which includes the Clytoria ternati, then Glycyrrhiza glabra. These plants are the medicinal plant. Glycyrrhiza glabra used in a cough and cold, while the plant like Clytoria is used against the snake bite. Some of the pulses. First one is a Sisar aratinum, chana plant, or what is called as a हरभरा, ओके, इन मराठी इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ हरभरा. द लीव्स आर यूज एज अ वेजिटेबल एंड सीड्स आर प्रोटीन एसिड न्यूट्रिशियस वन. ऑल पल्सेस आर न्यूट्रिशियस एंड रिच इन प्रोटीन्स. देन कजानस कजान, ग्लाइसिन मैक्स, दिस वन इज अगेन प्रोटीन रिच पल्स क्रॉप सीड यूज इन कुकिंग ऑयल एंड ऑयल केक इज यूज एज अ कैटल फीड. लैब लैब परप्रिया वाल पापड़ी विच इज वेजिटेबल. देन साइमोप्सिस टेट्रागोनोलोवा गवार प्लांट इज अ फ्रूट वेजिटेबल. फेजिवलस वल्गैरिस अगेन फ्रूट वेजिटेबल पल्स क्रॉप. विग्ना एकोनेटिफोलिया मठ प्लांट पल्स पल्स वन. देन विग्ना मुंगू उड़ीद प्लांट. विग्ना रेडिएटा मूंग प्लांट. विग्ना इंगिक्युलेटा चवली प्लांट. देन पायसम सटायवम वटाना प्लांट पी प्लांट. सो ऑल दीज आर द पल्स क्रॉप्स. देन पोंगामिया पिन्नाटा फ्रॉम विच ऑयल इज ऑप्टेन्ड विच इज यूज इन स्किन डिसीज एंड रिसोर्स ऑफ बायोडीजल. क्रोटोलारिया जुन्सिया इज यूज इन ग्रीन मैन्यूरिंग. देन फाइबर्स आर ऑप्टेन्ड फ्रॉम द स्टेम विच आर यूज इन प्रिपरेशन ऑफ रोप एज वेल एज गनी बैग्स. ट्रैगोनेला फ्यूनिकुलम दिस इज अ लिफी वेजिटेबल एंड यूज एज ए कॉन्डिमेंट. देन नेक्स्ट वन इज ए विटिया मोनोस्पर्मा फ्लावर यील्ड्स ऑइल एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द यूरिनरी एंड मेंस्ट्रुअल ट्रबल. एंड दिस वन इज अ टिम्बर प्लांट डालबर्जिया सिसु. आई होप यू माइट अंडरस्टूड दिस वन फैमिली. इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वन मोर फैमिली. टिल देन गुड बाय.